let's design something. You cannot do anything but a 7. 7 in one square, the mirror of the 7 will create your triangle. Now you can go ahead and have one side, and you can go ahead and have the other side. So now you have two sides. So this is like that. It's not a flat heart, it's like that. So then you would have the back side. You have the back side, and you got that, right? So you split it in the center. And then you go ahead and, let me turn this around and see what it does. I'm trying to figure this out, yes. And then you have to do it this way, and then this way. So now you have two 90 degrees, and now you flip them and you fold them together and you create the entire heart. So it takes 1, 2, 3, 4 areas, and now you have this. So these are what I call the stand. Take a stand. Only the black has a stand, the diamond. And how do you create the diamond? Well, let's take a heart. We'll take one heart, and I can do it this way, right? Or I can make my heart this way and then make my heart this way. I don't know if you've ever seen this design, I think in Alice in Wonderland, but it's irrelevant to the fact, because now what we're going to do is we're going to go down here and we're going to create the other hearts. So now when you put them together, you have an eye on each side, you have 88. And I like to call this the student. Same time, I put a pedestal joining the two sides. So let me show you what it looks like a little bit easier. Take it this way, and then you just go ahead and take it this way. So you have 88. I like to call them the students. 88 is for the word purple. 88 is also for the word Pegasus. And that's the square constellation. Constant. What is a consonant, right, in language? So what I do is I break things down. Consonant, language, the leaf, the stand on one side, the stand on the other side. And no matter which way, if this was a card in the deck of cards, it wouldn't matter which way the book would be. Right, it's the same thing. So I like to say diamonds are 2 for 1, in which when you had a club, and you flipped it upside down, I just like to play with them, you know what I'm saying? You flip the club upside down, it's upside down. So I only count it one way, but the diamond, I count both ways. So this suit, when you add up 1 through 9, equals to 45. You flip it upside down, it equals to 90. I like to count them both ways. See, although when you count the suit, the ace, let's say, has, let's do the heart. So if we were talking about the ace of hearts, you'd have it this way. I can flip it upside down, and then you'd see the ace of hearts looking this way. Okay, so it's 1 and 1. Here it's all the same. So if we counted 1 upside down, we flip over the card. There's only one way for the ace. Now the deuce would look like this. The 3 would look like this. It would be 2 and 1. The 4 card, the three card, 1, 2, 3. So here's 1 and 2 creating 3. The 4 card would give you the 4 corners. And then the 4 corners, and you would say that was 2 and 2. The 5 card would be 3 and 2. The six card would have 1, 2, 3, 4 up and 2 down. So the 7 card would be 1, 2, 3, 4, five, six, seven. And the eight card would be like this. So it'd be five and two. So if you go ace, deuce, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, you're going to end up with one up, one and one, two and one, two and two, three and two, four and two, five and two, five and three, and here you're going to end up with five and four. I like to call this electric company coming from the eight. What bring this to the singular value, okay, five and five is 10, seven and three is 10, call that one. I like to call that one the month of February, the month with 28 days running the cycle. Call this the electric company. Any craps, one and one, one and two, six and six, equals to 12, one and two equals to three. That runs through the heavens. The moons connect them. This is the birth, and this is the sun. This is the DNA. This is the earth through number seven, five and two. Half of anything, 0.5, five times any number, five times four equals to two. Forget about the 20. Bring it to a single digit. Two times two will equal to four. This two makes everything whole. Five cuts everything in half. The six is four and two. The five is three and two. The four is two and two. So you would end up with one and zero. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 13, 23, and five, 28. This side over here should be 17. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 4, 17. Cute. Stop on 17. The total is 45. If you would go to the Jack, Queen, King, they are picture cards. The total here is the 10 Jack, Queen, King. The 10 is 5 and 5. So I'm going to put 5 here and 5 here. I end up with 33. And I end up with 22, 6, and 4. You want to multiply it, you get 9, you get 4, you get 8, and you get 15. Where else can you get 8 and 15? 8 and 15 is, I'm just trying to remember, 72 and 53. Right, 5 times 3 is 15, 5 plus 3 is 8. The total is 23. There's another number that can do that, and that's 27. 27, 2 times 7 is 14, 2 plus 7 is 9, 23. You minus this, it equals to 5. You minus this one, equals to 7. 8 minus 15 is 7. 14 minus 9 is 5. Numeric value for moon is 57. And earth, another way to mark the numeric value for earth is 75, because that will make 3/4 of something, which leaves over 1/4, which is the representation of earth. 3/4 and 1/4, earth's value is 52.25. So we can also reverse these, turn these around, multiply them. I multiply this one, we got 23. I multiply this one, we got 17. 23 and 17. I multiply this one, I got 6 and 8, and we get the half-life. We get the house, and we get the planet. Here we get the what I like to call the student 11, yo 11. When you say yo 11, it comes from the game of craps. And yo equals to 25 and 15, Earth and Mars totaling 40 blue, or 10. We have to add on sixes to both of these, so this will be 71, or the gateway. And this is basically what it is, and here 1 and 0, let's call that 10. Let's say the ace is now valued at 7. And so now we have the ace is 7 and the 17 is 7, and we're back to Q again. So there's a whole lot of things we can do with numbers and the relationships. And are they real? Well, I went to the deck of cards to do this one. We did 88. We did the suits. And we all know that all the suits fit into each other. And how do the suits fit into each other? We're going to go the club and envelop it into the spade, and then we'll just do the heart over here. So by doing this, okay, we just have the full face of the club, right? Let me do this again. Let me see this, and then, right? I like to go like that, and like that. Let me do it again, okay? Like that. No, I'm doing it the wrong way. Sorry. Let me do this again. Let me get more paper here. No, that's not the way I wanted to do it either. It's another way we can look at number three. I wanted to. Oh yeah, there it is. So we have all really the suits here, because that little pinion here, the piece over here, it's like, I don't even know how to explain it. I didn't design this right. Anyways, the video is long enough. I want to say thank you for watching this video. Hebrew letter. Obligation for the dalet. You can do it this way, you can do it this way. You put both of these over each other, and then the center release valve is right over here, but let's not talk about this right now. Thank you for watching this video.